الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله محمد عبد الله ورسوله وصفيه من خلقه وحبيبه يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما ثم أما بعد عباد الله أوصيكم ونفسي بتقوى الله تعالى فهي وصية الله للأولين والآخرين يقول الله تعالى ولقد وصينا الذين أوتوا الكتاب من قبلكم وإياكم أن اتقوا الله. All the praises due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the one who deserves to be worshipped, Azza wa Jal. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded us in the Quran that we should be mindful to Him in several ayat in the Quran. And in the ayah that I mentioned in the last part, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded the people before us, those the people of the book, and advised us as well that we should be mindful to him and should be careful that we shouldn't transpass the limits that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put for us in the Quran and in the Sunnah. Our today's topic, inshallah ta'ala, is about something that we all seek and we all wanted to gain and get. And actually, it is in the sunnah of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that we always make dua for one another, for the believer that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give you barakah, we say barakallahu feek. And the answer we say, وَفِيكَ بَعَيْهِ اللَّهُ Allah, may Allah give you the same. When we have a newborn, we say, may Allah bless this newborn. May Allah give barakah. And the same with the marriage, we say, بَعَيْهِ اللَّهُ لَكُمَّا وَبَعَيْكَ عَلَيْهِمَا وَبَعَيْكَ عَلَيْهِمَا وَجَمَعَ بَيْنَهُمَا فِي خَيْرٍ. And this example goes on and on. The same we say for Ramadan, we say Ramadan Mubarak, and Eid Mubarak, and so on. And this barakah, the Prophet Muhammad mentioned in many hadith, and in one of the hadith which is authentic, that at our times the barakah will be less in our time and our money. As we notice, the cost of living has increased, the barakah in our time is not the same as before. And this is actually, it is something that even the Sahaba of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam complained to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned in this hadith that لَا تَقُومُ السَّاعَةَ حَتَّى يَتَقَارَبَ الزَّمَانُ فَتَكُونَ السَّنَةُ كَالشَّهْرِ وَيَكُونُ الشَّهْرُ كَالْجُمُعَةِ وَتَكُونُ الْجُمُعَةُ كَالْيَوْمِ وَيَكُونُ الْيَوْمُ كالساعة وتكون الساعة كاحتراق الساعة. So that the hour will not come until the time shrinks. So the year will be like a month, and the month will be like a week, and the week will be like a day, and the day will be like an hour, and the hour will be like a fire in the bush. That means time goes very fast. And the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, another authentic hadith, mentioned and linked this to the sins and to the certain kinds of corruption. So he mentioned in this hadith that لا تقوم الساعة حتى يتقارب الزمان وينقص العمل ويلقى الشح وتظهر الفتن ويكثر الهرج. So that the hour will not come until the time shrinks. And ينقص العمل, that means people, they will not do good deeds as before. And يلقى الشح, the stinginess and شح will place in the heart of the believer. They don't like to give. They have that شح in their heart. And يكثر الهرج, the killing will be prevalent. So that is one of the reasons that the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ mentioned that why the barakah will not be as before, because of all of these sins and the consequence of those sins. And unfortunately, people, they don't appreciate and realize the importance of their time until they get older, until they lose their, you know, they become busy, their health will not be as before, so then they will realize the importance of their time. And that's why the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam directed us to the two gifts, two ni'am, that many people, they don't pay attention to. Ni'matani maghbunun feehima kathirun minan nas, as-sihhatu wal-farag. Two gifts, two blessings Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us, many people, they don't pay attention to. The health, your health, and your free time. Actually, your free time is your umr, is your age. So you have to take care of it. And spend it only in the things that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wanted you to be. So what is barakah? Many people, they will ask this question, what do you mean by barakah? Because we don't see it, we don't touch it, so just we want, what do you mean by barakah? Maybe a good example for this, just remember the month of Ramadan, last month, you see how that month was full of barakah. People, they compete for goodness, they come for prayer, they donate, they pray at night, and yet they still wake up in the morning and go to work. Look at this barakah. Maybe we couldn't do that in any other month of the year. So this is one of the a clear example of the taqwa, of barakah. So barakah is when you work a little, but you have a big outcome. When you do a little bit of work, but the achievement is a huge or big in comparison to the time that you spend. This is one of the meaning of the barakah. Ibn Ata'illah defined the barakah, and he said, رُبَّ عُمُرٍ اتَّسَعَتْ آمَادُهُ
وقلت أمداده، ورب عمر قليلة آماده، كثيرة أمداده. So he said, Ibn Ata'illah, he's one of the wise scholar. He said, some people, they live very long life, but with little bit of fruit. They don't have big achievement in their life. And some people, they live very short life, but they have big achievement. They author books, they teach students, they have students everywhere. Like Imam al-Nawawi, in his book, Riyad al-Saliheen, he died at age of 40 or 42. But look at the books that he left behind. Every masjid in this globe has that book, the book of Riyad al-Saliheen. And look at how much barakah Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala put in this scholar, Al-Imam al-Nawawi, radiyallahu anhu. And when we talk about barakah, it's not necessarily that you do big achievement, but we also looking at the quality, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is looking at the deed with good quality. As mentioned in Surah Tabarak, لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. He tests you so he can see the best among you, the better of you. So in this khutbah, inshallah, I will go through 7 ways. If we do, inshallah, we will gain barakah, bi'idhnillah ta'ala, in our life, in our time, in our wealth, bi'idhnillah ta'ala. So first of all, at-tabkir, the morning. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned in the hadith, hadith authentic, that burika li ummati fi bukuriha. So you should start your day early in the morning. So that will give you more barakah in your time. You'll be able to achieve more during your day. So you start your day with a fajr prayer and then the adhkar. And as you notice in the Quran, subhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when talk about fajr, he always like link it to something important. Like for example, when Allah says in the Quran in Surah Al-Isra, وَقُرْآنَ الْفَجْرِ إِنَّ قُرْآنَ الْفَجْرِ كَانَ مَشْهُودًا. So the Quran of the Fajr is witnessed by Malaika. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said about Al-Fajr, the sunnah of Al-Fajr, رَكْعَتَا الْفَجْرِ خَيْرٌ مِنَ الدُّنْيَا وَمَا فِيهَا. So this is all barakah is related to this time. It is a blessed time. That's why we have to take advantage of the early morning time. So point number 2, that we should avoid sins. Because when you do sins, you ruin your good deeds. Because you know, you have a clear water and you spoil it with an ink, so then the clearness will go away. So the same, the sins will accumulate in your heart and prevent all good, you know, the understanding, the application of your amal. So that's why we should avoid the sins, because it makes like a barrier between our amal and the acceptance. And that will take the barakah from our life. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in the Quran, ولو أن أهل القرى آمنوا واتقوا لفتحنا عليهم بركات من السماء والأرض ولكن كذبوا. Had the people of town have faith and taqwa, and when we talk about taqwa, he's that you avoid sins, then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bring down all the barakat. ولكن كذبوا. So when they start doing sins, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala take that barakah from them. So the next point about taqwa, about barakah, that you spend time with your family. So when you spend more time with your family, that will bring barakah in your time and in your wealth. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من أراد أن يبارك له في عمره وينسأ له في أثره فليصل رحمه. So whoever wants to be granted more wealth and have their life extended, then let them keep a good relation with with their family ties. And this, subhanAllah, sometimes is challenging because people will question that. They will say, how come that we spend more time and we have more barakah? Because when we spend more time with our family, that means we're losing some of our times. But subhanAllah, the design for this universe and how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala designed his deen, that when we put more effort for his sake, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us barakah. And if you want examples, you look at the time of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, how many things he was able to achieve that maybe needs decades, needs generations after generations to achieve what the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam achieved and his Sahaba, and that is because of barakah. They used to pray at night. They used to spend their like whole wealth, and yet they still Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give them barakah in their time, barakah in their rizq. And number four, the acts of gratitude. So when we are thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that would make barakah more in our time. وَإِذْ تَأَذَّنَ رَبُّكُمْ لَإِنْ شَكَرْتُمْ لَأَزِيدَنَّكُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in Surah Ibrahim that when you are grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and being thankful to Him, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will increase you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will increase you in the same way that you strive for. For example, you donated your money, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you back your money and maybe even increase it. وَمَا أَنْفَقْتُمْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ فَهُوَ يُخْلِفُهُ. And if you donated your time by volunteering, by service, and that would make barakah in your time. Like what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentioned in Surah 7, اعملوا آل داود شكرا. He said that you're showing your gratefulness by action. Many people, they think that showing thankfulness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is just by saying Alhamdulillah or Shukrulillah, but this is not enough. You have to show by your action that you are grateful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that would give you barakah in your life. Number five, to get barakah by reciting Quran and especially Surah Al-Baqarah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, كِتَابٌ أَنْزَلْنَاهُ إِلَيْكَ مُبَارَكٌ. This book is a blessed book. So if you get busy with this book, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give you barakah in your health, in your wealth, in your time, in your mind. And specifically about Surah Al-Baqarah, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, اقرأوا سورة البقرة فإن أخذها بركة وتركها حسرة ولا تستطيعها البطلة. Possess and recite Surah Al-Baqarah, because when you read it, you will get barakah out of it. وتركها حسرة. Whoever abandoned the surah, he will be regret. He will feel regretful in the day of judgment. وَلَا تَسْتَطِيعُهَا الْبَطَلَ. No harm will touch you because of hasad or ayn or any what magicians do usually to harm people. If you read this surah al-Baqarah, you'll be protected بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى. أقول ما تسمعون أستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروه يغفر لكم إنه هو الغفور الرحيم ولا حول ولا قوة إلا بالله. الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين ولا عدوان إلا على الظالمين. أحمده سبحانه وتعالى ونستعينه ونستغفره من كل الذنوب والخطايا ونتوب إليه. I will mention two more points quickly for the sake of time about the things that if we do we get barakah in our time and our wealth. That after reciting Quran, especially Surah Al-Baqarah, that we should incorporate some dhikr in our life. So many people sometimes they do their work, let's say driving or working on the machine, or maybe ladies, they work in the kitchen, but they keep silent, they don't remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it is wise that we should use this time that we remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala by dhikr, by saying subhanallah, alhamdulillah, by saying la ilaha illallah, by saying astaghfirullah. So you're gaining the work you're doing, and at the same time you're getting hasanat by the dhikr. And that will eventually affect your heart and give you barakah in your time. And the proof for that, when the Sahaba radhiyallahu alayhim, they were like traveling, approaching Mecca, they reached a mountain called Jumdan. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said, Siru hadha Jumdan, sabaq al-mufarridun, sabaq al-mufarridun, sabaq al-mufarridun. He said, go for Jumdan mountain. The loners, that means the one who have lived their life of being alone, al-mufarridun. He said, they preceded. So from that, the Sahaba radhiyallahu anhum, they took. So the end of the hadith, the Sahaba radhiyallahu anhum asked, who are the al-mufarridun? What are they? So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, al-dhakirin Allah kathiran wal-dhakirat. So those who remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will make their life easy, will make them, you know, ahead of other people, those who doesn't remember Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And last one is by keeping a company with good people. So don't waste your time with people who are wasting their time, because you will not get any benefit from them. So accompany the people who remind you with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, remind you with the dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there is a story, short story about that, when Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu, he was like a small boy, like 10 years old. He wanted to encourage his friends that they should seek the knowledge from the Sahaba radiallahu anhu. And he met with one of his friends. He was like playing with the birds. And he told him, let's go and seek knowledge from the Sahaba radiallahu anhu. And that boy, he said, you know, let me alone, I just want to relax. I want just to have my time. So he just ignored him and went to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu. And he started seeking knowledge, start working hard, start sleeping in the masjid, praying with the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam at night. And he used to sleep at the doorstep of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam house. And after 3 years, people start pointing at Ibn Abbas and said, look at this young man, look at his knowledge, look how he's like, his manner. So just a few years make that huge effect because of the time, because how much time he invested and worked hard for himself. So bin Allah ta'ala, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he bless us with the wisdom that we should, you know, keep remembering him and ask him to give us barakah in our time. Allahumma a'izzal Islam wal Muslimin. Allahumma a'izzal Islam wal Muslimin. Allahumma a'izzal Islam wal Muslimin. Allahumma ansur deenaka wa kitabaka wa sunnata nabiyyika ya rabbal alamin. Allahumma ya muthabbit al-qulub, thabbit qulubana ala deenik. Allahumma ya musarrif al-qulub, sarrif qulubana ala ta'atik. Allahumma ya musarrif al-qulub, sarrif qulubana ala ta'atik. اللهم ارزقنا البركة في الوقت والعمر يا رب العالمين. اللهم ارزقنا تلاوة القرآن آناء الليل وأطراف النهار على الوجه الذي يرضيك عنا برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات والمؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات، إنك سميع قريب مجيب الدعوات يا رب العالمين. اللهم اشف مرضانا، اللهم اشف مرضانا، اللهم عاف بلدانا، اللهم ارحم موتانا برحمتك يا ارحم الراحمين. عباد الله، ان الله يامر بالعدل والاحسان وايتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون. واقم الصلاه.